warning, today is the special on Winter Olympics. Many might view aerial and mogul skiers as crazy adrenaline seekers, but I'm going to tell you how the physics behind it all is actually pretty simple. First, let's take a look at our athletes.
9 athletes have been chosen to represent the United States in Sochi to compete as the freestyle ski team for aerials and moguls, including Hannah Kearney, who received a gold medal at the Olympics in Vancouver for women's moguls. In addition to the normal required equipment for all skiers, skis, poles, goggles, ski boots, and helmets, mogul skiers are also required to have colored knee pads in order for the judges to easily view the form of their legs. Aerial skiers ski with all of the normal required equipment except for ski poles because their arms play an important role in executing their tricks. Mogul skiers will ski down a bump flattened hill and perform flips off of short ramps. They will be judged on the time and ability it takes for them to maneuver the course. Aerial skiers will have 2 chances to ski off ramps, reaching speeds up to 45 miles per hour before being propelled up to 50 feet into the air. They will be judged on takeoff, form, landing, and of course their ability to execute difficult tricks in the air.
In order to compete with the most accuracy and precision, competitors must fully understand the physics involved in their event. One of the most basic principles in skiing is the energy a skier has. Skiers have both potential and kinetic energy. Potential energy is the amount of energy a body has based on its position, while kinetic energy is simply the amount of energy a body has due to its motion. Let's take a look at how these types of energy are related to the skiing events in the Olympics.
At the top of a run, all skiers have potential energy, which is converted into kinetic energy as the skier descends the hill. Before leaving the ramp, aerial skiers push off the ground to create a rotational force called torque, which allows them to rotate and twist while they're in the air. Since they move in a rotational motion instead of a linear motion, the aerialists have angular momentum, which is simply the amount of momentum a rotating object has. By pushing off the ramp, the aerialists gain angular momentum, which is important because it gives them that initial rotation. Once they're in the air, there is no way to change their angular momentum, and the only way to control the rotations is for the aerialists to control their moment of inertia. To control their moment of inertia, aerialists use their arms and legs. By doing this, they are altering their mass from one side of their body to the other, which is how they are able to complete fancy tricks while they're in the air. In addition to performing tricks on much shorter ramps, mogul skiers must also maneuver around the bumps formed. In order to do this, they use up and down leg movement to absorb the shock. It is very important for mogul skiers to keep their center of mass constant in order to stay balanced and in control. To do this, the skiers don't use a lot of upper body movement. In order for all skiers to improve their performance on the snow, they wax the bottom of their skis to reduce the amount of friction while skiing. This allows them to have higher initial velocity when preparing to perform their stunts. In addition to this, skiers also use a stone grinder to sharpen the edges of their skis so it is easier to stop and turn on the snow.
Hopefully you learned a lot about aerial and mogul skiing. And who knows, maybe you'll try it yourself now that you know all the physics behind it. Thanks for watching.